Hello and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel in the first place. Today, we have a Todoroki X listener. If you're in the live chat, be respectful to the moderators, otherwise let's go ahead and get into it. As a hero, there wasn't too much to be excited about when the first snow came in. It meant car accidents, mountain rescue assist, and various other equally inane activities that required your attention. This year was no different. If how many calls your team had been getting over the past few days, the first was a four-car pileup on the entrance to the highway. Nobody was killed, thankfully, but it had interrupted your morning routine. The next day had consisted of rescuing an elderly couple from a rural home after the snow piled up and the EMTs couldn't get to them in time. Your partner Todoroki had been helpful in this situation, easily melting all the piled up snow with his fire quirk. However, both of you failed to remember that in freezing temperatures, melted snow was water, and when it pooled on the ground, it created slick ice to slip on. "I apologize," the hero said, his tone neutral and unreadable as if he actually meant it. "I forgot how cold it was." With his quirk, he rarely had to worry about the outside temperature, as he could easily regulate his own. You, on the other hand, were in a thick winter coat, insulated pants, socks, and specially designed anti-slip boots. The EMTs were not nearly as lucky. One of them clenched their jaw as they groaned in pain. "It's fine, nothing broke." Although it would leave a nasty bruise on their hip. You could tell by how hard he fell. You had done that one too many times to not know how painful that was. It was the reason you had asked for these boots in the first place. Shoto may have mastered his quirk, but his situational awareness still needed some work in your opinion. "So, are we gonna go get a break for lunch, or do we have to be whisked away to Oz yet again, Dorothy?" It was still a little amusing to see Shoto connect the dots to your joke. Not that he was laughing. He rarely did that. Most of your jokes went over his head anyways, and into the next town over. Shoto had a quizzical look on his face as he scrolled through his phone. "No, we got a request for some help in a ski resort." He paused as he continued reading. "There was an avalanche on the higher ski pass, an undetermined amount of visitors have been caught up in it." His tone wasn't necessarily casual, but neither did it sound stressed or maybe concerned, like you were when you heard about the conditions. An undetermined amount of visitors, trapped in snow, and he read it like a tweet. "We should get going then," you pointed out, hurrying to the agency. There was a helicopter, thanks to Shoto's family inheritance, and a pilot on standby, so the travel time was cut down exponentially. "What's the plan?" you wondered as you two climbed aboard. Your quirk was useful for finding people, but getting there was a whole other situation. "Locate the survivors," Shoto replied simply, his bi-colored eyes staring at you. "Provide aid until the EMTs arrive." You smirk. "Think we can get a ski ride in before your next call?" Shoto was not amused, nor impressed by your jest. "I don't know." You whined. "You're no fun, Shoto. At least Deku and Dynamite can play along." "I'm not Deku or Dynamite," he pointed out. You wish the number three hero realized he was exactly making your point. The rescue was a little more complicated than either of you had anticipated. Melting the snow at first was the simple solution, just like the prior situation. But instead of creating an icy floor, Shoto ran the risk of accidentally lighting someone on fire. One of the downsides of your quirk was that even though you could sense people, you didn't have their exact location, so you two managed. It took longer than you expected, and there were about as many complaints as there were compliments on your hard work. In your defense, the mountain was large and snow had piled up higher than the initial reports had claimed. Shoto could only defrost so much before he needed a break. "You should get some water," he said. "I think the other rescue workers and I can handle it from here." He shook his head, sweating far more than someone in 8-degree weather should ever be able to sweat. I'm fine. We can take the ski lift back. It was at times like this when you wished you had a higher rank than him. Maybe then he would actually listen to you, rather than discount every other word that wasn't work-related. An hour passed and the last survivor was taken into care. Both Todoroki and you were exhausted after rifling through snow and ice for the majority of the afternoon. He looked far worse than you did, arms a bit shaky, legs swaying. You took his arm and wrapped it around your shoulders. Come on, hot stuff. Let's get you back to the agency so you can take a real break. I'm fine, he assured. And I'm the President of the United States, he countered as you pulled him along, his body beginning to lean on you more and more as you approached your destination. Now get on the damn ski lift, or so help me God, I will let you fall down this mountain in a man-sized snowball. That's impossible. I would stop myself with my quirk before I ever fell that far. You groaned. Just get on the fucking ski lift half and half. Was it just you, or did the former Class 1A students have an extremely difficult time accepting help? They went through all of that in high school, and still, they didn't learn that aside from proper teamwork, admitting you needed help was the next most important skill to learn. Silently and reluctantly, he complied. The trip down the mountain was slow, but smooth. Neither of you spoke, and Shoto wasn't much for small talk. He preferred silence. His eyes didn't look at you as you rode the ski lift down, instead examining the surroundings around him. The tall pine trees covered in blankets of snow, dots of people continuing to ski down the mountain, and the sights of snowflakes drifting down towards the ground. You know the reason I became a rescue hero? You inquired. Shoto barely acknowledged you with a small hum. An accident kinda like this happened when I was a kid, you informed to fill the weighted silence. The memory still as bright as a light bulb when you began to recall it. My entire family was under the snow. You remembered how your lungs burned. Your skin felt as if ice piled under several feet of snow. I initially didn't want to go, but if I hadn't... You didn't like to think about that part. There was another minute of silence before Shoto spoke. I saw you at the licensing exam. You were really passionate about rescuing civilians. He didn't want to look at you after saying that. The smile on your face was far too bright, too positive, too energetic for someone who had just spent their day in below freezing temperatures. I should have asked for tips. I would have given them to you. You smiled as you elbowed him playfully, free of charge. Shoto didn't know what the heated feeling in his chest was, or how to hide the growing blush on his face, so he looked away, hoping it was a good enough excuse. I think we'll be able to go home after this. We should get something to eat. Yeah, I'm starving, you informed him, feeling your stomach rumble. Careful though, I might think the number 3 hero is asking me on a date. Isn't that what it is? He laughed. You know what? The ski lift stopped at the edge of the platform, the bar lifting as you pushed. I guess it's close enough. Alright, so that's the end of this one. I hope you enjoyed. If you're in the live chat, thank the moderators. Otherwise, music link, fanfic link, Discord link, and thumbnail art link are all in the description. I hope to see you in the next one, and I hope you have a great rest of your day, night, whatever. Goodbye!